Hello guys, this is Adriana and in today's video we have a lot of things to talk about, as every Sunday. Unemployment rates, small businesses loans, analyze Uber, Lyft and Disney's earnings report, and then at the end of the videos I will give you guys my expectations for next week's earnings for Marriott and Norwegian. Why is the stock market rallying if the economy is so bad? Nearly 33.5 million US workers have filed applications for unemployment benefits in just 7 weeks since closure. That pushed April job losses to record levels. I don't think we'll be able to recover those unemployment numbers that fast. It could still be many months before the labor market really returns to a point where US employers constantly add more jobs than they subtract. The thing is that the increase in unemployment will have a follow-up effect in the form of lower consumer spending, and that will make it even more difficult to recover the economy. Still, if we really reopen the economy this month, there will be a lot of rules where, for example, restaurants could only have 6 people per table and each table needs to be 6 feet apart. And that means less workers required daily and less customers in each restaurant. The other thing about unemployment is that it takes time to get your unemployment benefits, and that is going to cause, if it hasn't already, a lot of people to not be able to pay for their mortgages on time and face a possibility of housing foreclosure. Now, the Small Business Administration decided to apply a new restriction for federal business disaster loans. Originally, applicants were eligible for up to $2 million in loans, and every small business could apply. Now, the SBA changed everything by only allowing applications from agricultural businesses, and the amount was limited to up to $150,000 per business, from $2 million to $150,000. All this will cause a huge impact later on, since a lot of small businesses like restaurants need help to sustain, and now that they are not getting that help, they are running out of options and majority of them will have to permanently close. After all this is when I ask myself, what is driving the stock market rally? I mean, the disconnect between the economy and the stock market is incredible. It's like they are divorced. For me, it's a speculation and faith. People have faith that April possibly marked the bottom in many industries. Also, people are forecasting a speedy recovery because some restaurants and bars are already opening in some states. Oil prices are slowly climbing back up. Potential COVID-19 treatment is being tested. As I said, everything is because faith and speculations that we are going to be back to normal. Now, don't get me wrong, it would be amazing to be back to normal sooner than expected, but there is no certainty of anything. Another reason that is driving this rally is that quarter one earnings showed us how affected companies were, and we realized that it wasn't as bad as expected. The 5 big tech stocks are leading the market: Amazon, Google, Facebook, Microsoft, and Apple. And Nasdaq Composite Index even enters to positive territory for the year already. Additionally, a big fear among some investors is that they could be missing out a sooner than expected recovery, since they were actually expecting another decline. Now, let's analyze Uber, Lyft and Disney earnings report, and then I'll give you guys my expectation for next week's earnings. If you're wondering what my thoughts on Shopify earnings report are, I'm gonna be posting a video on Tuesday, May 12th, so stay tuned. First, Uber. They reported an increase of 14% in their revenue and a net loss of $2.9 billion, which is an increase in their loss of 190% in comparison to quarter one of 2019. Now, you have to take into consideration that $2.1 billion out of that $2.9 billion that they had in losses were impairment charges. Still, they saw an increase of 2% on their rides and 53% on Uber Eats, which was expected with everyone being at home. Now, for their balance sheet, their assets decreased 25%, while their liabilities increased 7% year over year. They explained that they are planning a reduction of $1 billion in fixed costs, which includes a 14% reduction of staff. Their CFO, Nelson Chai, said that those measures could put the company in a position to be profitable in 2021. Now, remember that they said that they could be profitable by the end of this year, 2020, on an adjusted EBITDA, which is earnings before interest, taxes, depreciation, and amortization. But on April, they decided to withdraw that forecast because of the sharp drop in demand due to COVID-19. In my opinion, their actual timing to profitability will really depend on the speed of the recovery. Second, Lyft. They reported an increase of 23% in their revenue for quarter one And in comparison with Uber, they actually reported an improvement on their net loss of 65% in comparison to quarter one of 2019, where they had a loss of over $1 billion. Their assets decreased 2%, while their liabilities increased 4.5%. Also, they reported that they already cut 17% of their staff. Now, it's important to know that both companies said that they have already seen a slight pickup in ride sharing in recent weeks, and that both companies are facing a current lawsuit in California. The lawsuit is basically because they misclassify workers as constructors, since they deny their workers or riders their key benefits and protection. The thing is that Uber and Lyft decided to treat their riders as contractors and not workers because that is what gives them the flexibility of hours worked and be able to work for both Uber and Lyft at the same time. In my opinion, if they are imposed to give their riders those benefits, then workers will be asked to work a minimum number of rides or hours per day. Last but not least, Disney. They reported an increase in revenue of 20% since quarter two of 2019 and a decrease in their net income of more than 90%, which is a huge decline since they had to shut down all their parks, hotels, and cruises around the world. Still, their cash and cash equivalents saw a huge increase of 165%, but a slight increase of 6.3% on their assets. Disney saw an increase of 28% on their media network, which are all the cable channels, radio, and digital businesses. Then another increase of 18% on studio entertainment, which are Pixar, Marvel, Lucasfilm, and so on. More than 100% on direct to customers and international, which are Hulu, ESPN+, Disney+, national and internationally. And then a decrease of 10% on parks, experience, and productions, as it was expected. They are suspending dividends for the first half of fiscal year. That move would actually preserve $1.6 billion in cash for the company. They will go back to business this month since they are reopening its Shanghai Disney Park tomorrow, May 11th. Obviously, not with their typical 100% operations since the government said that they could only operate at 30% capacity. Still, tickets for reopening on Disney Resort have already sold out. For next week, we have a bunch of companies reporting earnings like Marriott, Logitech, Sony, Wix, Norwegian, and a bunch of others as you can see here in this little chart. But for this video, we'll be analyzing Marriott and Norwegian. First, Marriott International is a company that has seen a slow growth over the last 3 years, since as you can see here, their revenue has barely increased as well as their net income. Their cash on hand has decreased, but their total asset has actually increased by almost 6%, while their liabilities increased 13%. Because of all that, their equity has decreased a whopping 68%. Take into consideration that that was all before the coronavirus started. So during this crisis, they announced a new $1.5 billion in revolving credit facility, which increased Marriott's liquidity. As of April 14th, more than 25% of the hotels were temporarily closed. Obviously, I do expect this number to increase even more. For Marriott, I'm expecting them to have a significant decrease in revenue since they were not doing very well lately. Plus, the coronavirus hit the industry very hard. Second, Norwegian. Most of you may already know that I started investing in the cruise line industry since December of 2019. I own Carnival and Royal Caribbean stocks, but have never invested into Norwegian. And let me tell you why. Yes, Norwegian is a company that's been having a good growth over the past years, but not as exponential as Royal Caribbean and Carnival, as you can see here in this chart. Last year, they had an increase of over 6% in their revenue and actually a decrease of 3% on their net income. Back on April, they said that their demand was almost zero for the rest of the year. They have already taken extreme actions to be able to sustain since they are estimating its cash burn to be around $110 and $150 million per month during suspensions of operations. Do you know what that? Burning $110 and $150 million in a month. That's like disappeared in a minute. To reduce their expenses meaningfully, they had to decrease crew, payroll, food, fuel, insurance, port charges, marketing, and so on. So for them, I expect them to have a loss for the year and a significant decrease in their revenue in comparison to previous years, obviously. I'm saying this because they are missing out their best season, which is summer season. And also, I don't expect the demand to recover for this year, even if we are able to hop on a cruise before year ends. And now guys, after this video, I do recommend you go and watch this video, which are the 5 stocks I might be buying on May this month, and then this playlist, which is recommended by YouTube. Thank you for watching, I hope you really enjoy it. Don't forget to subscribe, smash the like button for the YouTube algorithm. Thank you, stay safe, stay home, see you next time.